Hi, and welcome to this session on cross-environment consolidation. My name is Brian Nelson. I'm a program manager in the Business Central team. We're going to show a new feature that is expanding the consolidation feature, or sub-feature to the consolidation feature. What we will do in this session is a brief recap of consolidation. I'll show you how it's done in a normal case. Then we will show you how it's done in with the new feature where you are doing cross-environment consolidation. It looks the same, but it is different. And then Joshua will take you through how you set it up. There's a bit of work and not much. And lastly, Joshua will give you some tips and tricks. But let's look at what is consolidation. Consolidation is when you need to import or consolidate your financial statements from multiple business entities, if you're a group of businesses, to get a complete overview of the group. We call them business units, the subsidiary or sales offices, or any other legal entity that you have. We can support multi-currency, so the subsidiaries don't have to have the same currency as the parent or holding company that you're consolidating into. There is a feature so that you can map the chart of accounts. They don't have to be the same. You'll just do the mapping in the subsidiary to the consolidation company's chart of accounts. And we also handle minority interest. But let's just take a brief look at how the feature looks like. So in this company, you can see that in my environment, and this is the same environment, I have two, like I have actually a lot more companies. I have my holding company, and I have two other companies, Brian's Beans and Joshua's Coffee. These are my two subsidiaries to the holding company. I've set them up as business units. And for these, I have done some specifications. I specify what the name is, what currency rate I want to use. It can be the subsidiaries or the holding companies. And you can choose to use the currency exchange rate or the currency exchange rate for the additional reporting currency. You can also define how much you want to consolidate. And if you don't consolidate 100%, so you have minority interest, we'll still do the consolidation. But then also post, when you do the consolidation, we'll post the offsetting entries for the minority interest. And then there are accounts to handle the gains and losses if you are doing a subsidiary in currencies. The bottom part, we'll get to that in a second. So I've set up these companies. I've done some importing. And what you can do is you can run a trial balance for consolidation. You can also set up, because it's business units, you can do financial reporting. And I've created a report here called consolidation per business unit. And you'll be able to see, if I scroll down a bit, that I have my incorporated, the holding company. I have beans and coffee, and then I have something extra. And I have numbers for at least the beans, because that's the one I've imported so far. But you can import your businesses, and then through financial reporting or an external BI tool, you can get an overview of your combined business. So up until now, it worked with within environment companies. So these two that are in the same environment, I could just hit the consolidate button and it would import the data from these companies. If the company resided somewhere else in the world, different region, different environment, I would have to use files to import and export my consolidation information. But we have changed it for this session, as Joshua will show. You set up a company that is in a different environment.
So let's have a look at how we can import data from a different environment. So here I am in my holding company, and here I have only a US subsidiary, and I want to import data from the US subsidiary and also from a British subsidiary, Kronos GBP Beans. So let's see. In the holding company, you can go to the business units page. Here I have them already set up, and I can click the action consolidate. And I can set up the starting date, the ending date for this consolidation, the document number with which you want to identify the entries that get posted in this company. And yeah, this gets pre-filled with the currency that this company has. In this case, it's USD. So when you want to run the consolidation, you are presented with a list of the business units that you have. In case you need to authenticate because you haven't run consolidations recently, you have to select this and it will prompt you to click this grant access action that will prompt an authentication flow and see that you actually have access to that company. In this case, we have access, so we can just go ahead and say finish. Now the consolidation is successful and we can see these entries in this company. So now that we have performed the consolidation, let's see and have a look at the data that were exported from the other company. So here in our holding company, I can go to financial reports. And here I have the same financial report Brian showed. And here I have the different accounts and I have a total what's in each of the business units. For the consolidation period that we selected. So let's have a look at how we can set up some the business units for cross-environment. So we go to the business units page, and just as before, we can add a new business unit. Here we will add the British beans company that we have. And the main difference on how you set up this is that now you can set up an API type here. When you do this, then you can consolidate across environments. It doesn't necessarily need to be in this same environment. So, and it requires an API endpoint. So how can you get this endpoint? You can get this through the page consolidation setup in the other company. So here it is my subsidiary company. So if we go to the page consolidation setup, we will see an environment endpoint. We can copy this and then we can paste it here. After this, you will be required to authenticate in that company. So in this page, you have to authenticate with the user in the other company. And after this is done, you are required to select which company in this environment you want to set up. So it's this one, and that's it. You have now a new business unit that can communicate with it. Yeah, something important to note also is that before doing this consolidation setup, you have to enable this company as a subsidiary. So when you toggle this, you can import data. If you at any time don't want data to be extracted from this company, you can disable this.
Yes, perfect. So now you can consolidate companies that are either in the same environment or in a completely different environment. If you then do the mapping for currencies or for the chart of accounts, it should be a smooth process from now on. Joshua, you may have some tips and tricks.
Yeah, so just as a general overview of what happened, this new consolidate action and that has this wizard. You may have been familiar with the report that we had before. The report still exists and won't be deprecated, so you can still use it. And we use it for the database. So the procedures for running the consolidation are internal, so we don't expose them right now, but you can run this wizard from your AL code. And yeah, that's just it.
Just a small thing.
Small warning.
Nice to know. Yeah. Thank you. We hope you like the feature and will start using it for your consolidation going forward. Thanks for joining this session.